So today we will understand coefficient of restitution in a real life with experiment.
Namaste all and welcome back to Physicist. So in this video we are going to understand the coefficient of restitution with a very practical example. It's all made easy with this experiment. So after watching this video, you will be able to use the coefficient of restitution in a daily life examples. You know, there are tons of tasks that you do daily, like bouncing the ball and many more collisions around, and where there all you can use the coefficient of restitution. Okay, so basically the term coefficient of restitution tells you about the how bouncy is the something is. Okay, so like how bouncy is the ball is. The higher the value of the coefficient of restitution is, the higher the bouncy of the material of the object is. And simply, the lower the value of the coefficient of restitution is, the lower the bounciness.
So this is how the ball falls, usually under the free fall, and we can predict the next height using the coefficient of restitution. So let's get started. So h here is the height at rest, or the height of ball before the bounce, and h2 and h3 are the respective heights after the bounce. So this is the simple formula for coefficient of restitution, and it is represented by the e. So it's a height of ball after first bounce divided by the height of ball at rest, or the preceding height, and square root of the term. So it will give you the value of the respective heights and the coefficient of restitution, and similarly for the succeeding heights. So this is our scale for measuring the height of ball after the bounce. It starts from the 5 inches from the ground and then continues with a difference of 1 inches interval. So let's get started with the green ball. Here holding a ball exactly at 43 inches using a right angle and going to drop from the height. So you can see this is the first bounce and the height of it is 30 inches. So from this we got the values for h43 and h130, and solving further equation you can get the value of the coefficient of restitution, that is e. Okay, so for the plastic green ball, second bounce height, here we have to calculate and solve for the h2. So simply doing the math, you get the theoretical height calculated by the coefficient of restitution formula. And we got the value of height equals 20.93 inches. And now let's see the actual result, and we will compare the same without theoretical reading. Let's see the difference between the both. So here I'm going to drop the ball from 43 inch height, and as we have predicted the reading for our height after second bounce, let's check it out. So you can see here the third bounce and the both comparable heights from our theoretical reading plus the practical one. So let's get the second ball for reading, and this is a tennis ball made up of the rubber material, and we will calculate the value of coefficient of restitution for the same. Using the same formulae, we have calculated the value of coefficient of restitution, and solving the simple math you will get the height of second bounce also. So let's get started to see the actual reading and our calculated one. Let's compare both reading together. So this is the first bounce, and this is the value after the first bounce of the height, and after the first bounce the height will, as we have calculated from the equation, and this is the height after the actual one. So we can see the difference between both. So this is our red rubber ball and quite bouncy, so let's calculate the coefficient of restitution value for the same. So here is the simple equation, and you can see the height before the bounce is 43 inches, and the H1 is the height after the first bounce, which is 27.5 inches. And doing the simple math, you can get the value of coefficient of restitution. And after that, we will calculate the H2 height after the second bounce, and we will compare the results, actual one and the reading that we have got from our theoretical calculation. So using the right angle, I'm exactly going to drop the ball from the 43 inch height, and this is the first bounce, and it will reach the respective reading here. And after the second bounce, we will compare our theoretical calculation with the actual one. So these are the two readings, and let's see the difference. As you can see, there is no much difference between the two readings. So this is how you can use the coefficient of restitution in a real
object. Yes. So the coefficient of restitution is taking talking mathematically, is the dimensionless quantity because it is the coefficient, and the value of the coefficient of restitution generally lies between the 0 to 1. So 1 means the higher and 0 means the lower. So in a real life, that we use the value between the less than 1 and greater than 0, because for the 1, it's we consider it as a perfectly elastic collision. So basically, we will understand first the what are the collisions is. So in collisions, there are two main types. If we consider the perfectly elastic collisions and the perfectly inelastic collisions. For the value of the coefficient of restitution, that is the value of 1, that is the collision between the two objects is the perfectly elastic one. So what is the perfectly elastic collision is that basically, if you drop the ball from a certain height and it's accelerating due to the gravitational acceleration, that means the object is falling down purely due to the gravitational acceleration, or the free fall, you can say. And after dropping that ball or the object, it will reach the height exactly equal to your respective height before the bounce. Okay, so there in a perfectly elastic collisions, the kinetic energy is get conserved. What that means, the kinetic energy get conserved, is that there is no energy loss between the bounce. So when you drop the ball from the height, it will reach the same height because there is no energy loss. So in the real life, that doesn't happen. The perfectly elastic collision doesn't happen because when you drop a ball, the energy get wasted in making the sound energy that you hear the sound when you drop a ball down, or the little bit of heat is also created on the surface of the material of the object. That the heat lost from that collision is also compensate the resulting in the subsequent height of the ball that doesn't reach the similar height again of the previous one. Okay, so with the every subsequent bounce, the ball loses its energy in the form of sound waves and the heat energy, so that it loses the height also. Okay, so that's called the real life collisions, the real collisions. So that's come. So the value of the coefficient of restitution will fall down from the 1. Okay, actually, so it's never be the 1 for the real life collisions. And for the other things, like if you say the coefficient of restitution value equals to 0. So what that means is the collision between the real life or the collision is the perfectly inelastic one. So inelastic collision is you can say the kinetic energy is totally get absorbed during the collision. So what that means, when the particular ball or the particular object, when two objects collide together, the kinetic energy of the any one of them is moving, which is moving, or you can say the both object, if they are moving, they will stick together and will travel with the respective speed. Okay, so what that means is that the kinetic energy is get directly transferred to the other object, so that they will get stick together. So that also doesn't happen in real life. So the value of the coefficient of restitution will rise from the 0 and it will be the less than the 1. So the actual real life collisions will be these in between the 0 and 1. So when you are going to purchase a cricket ball, a professional cricket ball, there will be the value of COR that will tell you the how good the bouncy of the ball is. So if you say the COR, the coefficient of restitution, will be the between the 0 to 1, that means if you say for 0.9 value lies for the coefficient of restitution, so that will tell the ball is little bit bouncy.